With that, we move on to the Xfinity Series.
Yes,
one
we
tier
do.
Up onto the Saturday race at Phoenix as well. We've got Chase Briscoe, Justin Allgaier, Austin Cindric, and Justin Haley in the championship four. The surprise probably being there, Justin Haley, when you look at the likes of Ross Chastain, Noah Gregson, even Brandon Jones outside of that championship four in 2020. But Haley's done enough to skate through, and I think we start with him, Kyle. I imagine he's probably your fourth guy for the championship. He's mine for sure. I don't think he can really compete with these other three this weekend. I haven't seen enough from him on non-super speedway tracks and some other kinds of tracks as well. Something like this, I don't think fits Haley's driving style per se, but he did well at Richmond, if I'm not mistaken, earlier this this season for the Xfinity Series. So I could be wrong in that respect, but when I look at the competition he's going up against, I think those all three of these guys could win the championship against him. So I have Justin Haley fourth. I imagine you have the same.
Yeah, he's the longest shot for me as well. He was good in the playoff race at Phoenix last year, finished seventh ahead of Chase Briscoe. But that being said, I just feel like both Colleague and Justin Haley are that little bit step behind the rest of those three guys, specifically at Phoenix. If it was at a different track, then maybe I would have Haley ahead of somebody like Justin Allgaier. But given it is Phoenix and it's a track that suits Justin Allgaier as well as both Briscoe and Cindric, just because of the season-long success they've had everywhere, Justin Haley's got to be the longest shot to win the championship. That being said, with Briscoe, Cindric, Allgaier are probably going to be running all next to each other, anything can happen. And if Haley's maybe a spot or two behind those guys, who knows what can happen if there's some kind of contact or something where Justin Haley can come through and steal the win. But yeah, similar to you, I like Justin Haley quite a bit. But that being said, I haven't seen enough from non-super speedway races to put him up into that top three.
One thing I will say about Haley is that he can probably be the most aggressive of the four this weekend because he's got really nothing to lose. So I think in terms of pit strategy or a late call, if they want to gamble and not and lose
yeah,
that track
have to
position
try
and try and,
stuff, yeah.
And try and get some fresh tires compared to their competition, who are most likely going to be out front battling for the win, maybe they can try and sneak something and get in position where they can capitalize on a couple of late restarts if it does come down to that. But for myself, Haley's fourth, and for you as well, it's fourth. So we move on to third place here, Kyle. I don't think you can really go wrong with any of these guys in terms of who's left. I mean, you've got the two favorites most likely in Chase Briscoe and Austin Cindric for season long, but you can't forget about Justin Allgaier's success on these kinds of tracks as well. So who do you have as finishing third in the championship race at Phoenix?
This one pains me to say, because as we stand today, he currently leads the season long points total. But third for me is Austin Cindric. I just feel like at Phoenix, it's a track that obviously we've seen Justin Allgaier be so good at in the past, but I feel like it suits Chase Briscoe a little bit more than it does Cindric. And that being said, I think that all three of those guys are going to be super close this upcoming weekend. But I think Cindric is just going to be that number three guy out of that bunch.
I agree. I can't believe it. I didn't think that you would probably have him third, but you do. I have him third. Cindric has just been frustrating at times this season, where I think he's going to be good. And then he had that incredible stretch of 5 of 6 Xfinity Series wins. Like, it was just remarkable. But then since then, it hasn't been the exact same level of success. And when I look at that stretch that he had this season, it was phenomenal. But at the same time, when you look at the tracks, he's so good on the road courses. And then that Kentucky duo, it just kind of makes it look maybe greater than what it is. But at the same time, he's the season-long points champion right now. And he's been super consistent. He's had more top tens than Chase Briscoe, amazingly, which is – I can't believe that when it comes down to that. But – he does. He has 25 top tens this season, 25 top tens, 18 top fives compared to Briscoe's 16 and 21 respectively. So Briscoe's got more laps led, but Cindric's just been super consistent this season. So it's just going to come down to this, that little bit. And I don't know if Cindric has had enough pace on these kinds of tracks is similar to Haley in some respects to battle against Allgaier, who's the veteran of the series, and Briscoe, who's obviously going up to the Cup Series next season. So I have Cindric as third as well. So that leaves with the same duo with Justin Allgaier and Chase Briscoe remaining for both of us. Who is your championship winner for the Xfinity Series in 2020?
I said it before the playoffs started. I'm sticking with it. I'm going to say Chase Briscoe gets it done at Phoenix. Look, Justin Allgaier's got great numbers at Phoenix. He's the veteran of this championship four. But Chase Briscoe has just been otherworldly in terms of the race victories this season in the Xfinity Series. And I think he caps it off with a victory at Phoenix this weekend. He's going up to the 14 car next season with SHR. When that team is on their game, they're borderline untouchable. We've seen them a couple times in these playoffs put up the max 60 points in a race weekend, getting the stage wins and the race victory. While I don't think that we'll see that level of dominance, I think that just given how likely it was that this team was going to be in the championship race and locking it up in the first week, they've been able to prepare the longest. I think it's going to be damn tough to beat Chase Briscoe this weekend. So he is my Xfinity Series champion for 2020.
I do not have Chase Briscoe as my champion for 2020. I am sticking to my guns on the playoff start.
I like it. Sticking to our guns.
I'm going with Justin Allgaier. I feel like I couldn't back out at this point in time. I just wanted to stick with my initial prediction. He's run so well here in his career. It's incredible. There's I don't really think anybody comes close in terms of their performance at this track with who he's facing. And I don't know if he necessarily has the momentum, but he's been right there. I think kind of the forgotten of the trio with Cindric and Briscoe this season. He's been pretty damn good. He's got 932 laps led, but the number that sticks out for Allgaier this season in terms of that's probably separated or brought him back from those two is the 8 DNFs. And that's a lot for a guy that's in the championship four. But at the same time, when he's not been wrecking and not finishing the races, he's been basically top five material. So he's got 18 top tens, 10 top fives. So not the greatest numbers in the world there, but three wins is nothing to be shy about. And he won the Richmond races, both of them. So that's huge for Justin Allgaier with a very similar kind of package here with Phoenix. So I'm thinking that they're going to correlate in terms of speed, and I like the 7 car this weekend. So that means Chase Briscoe, once again, the guy that goes into here, probably the favorite amongst the championship four for myself for like the third year in a row here. I thought Christopher Bell the last two seasons, and he had had the most wins, and it seemed like it was destined for him. He didn't follow through, so I'm going to go away from that prediction that I've done the past two seasons and go with maybe a bit of an underdog here in Justin Allgaier and upset the favorite in Chase Briscoe.
Yeah, no, I'm a big fan of that pick. And, of course, Justin Allgaier won the playoff race at Phoenix last year. But something that's interesting to me is the Xfinity Series did go to Phoenix earlier this year. And of the championship four guys, only one of them finished inside the top five, which is kind of remarkable to say. Looking back at that race, of course, that was the race that Brandon Jones went out and beat Kyle Busch. I'm sure you remember that fondly. But it went Brandon Jones, Harrison Burton, Kyle Busch, Brad Keselowski, and finishing fifth, Justin Haley. So Justin Haley maybe might be the surprising guy this weekend, but finishing sixth in that race was Chase Briscoe as well. Austin Cindric, eighth, and then Allgaier, I believe, had some issues and finished 13th. So going to be very interesting to see that Xfinity Championship race. I think it does come down.
Don't let Haley win this, man. It cannot happen. I'm sorry.
I think it comes down to Briscoe, Allgaier, Cindric as well. And seeing those three battle it out for the championship is going to be great. Obviously, Briscoe running in the Xfinity Series full-time for the final time going up to SHR next year. Justin Allgaier looking to win his first Xfinity Championship for Junior Motorsports. And then Austin Cindric going to return to Penske as well. So going into next year, looking to win that championship this year and cement himself as the favorite going into next year.
Yeah, this is not Cindric's last shot. This is Briscoe's last shot. I don't know if Allgaier will have plenty more chances at this, most likely, in the Xfinity Series.
You would imagine.
And Haley's going to have another shot next season as well. So this is Briscoe's championship. He has to win it if he wants to get that that top echelon kind of status and that top prospect, maybe asterisk next to his name. But for right now, I'm going with Allgaier. He's going with Briscoe. So we have Justin Allgaier as the champion for my side of things, and Chase Briscoe for Kyle's, and Brett Moffitt for the Truck Series for both of us. So that comes down now, Kyle, to the big one on Sunday.